Afternoon, everyone. This is Tony from Her Homestead Skills. Yes, there's so much going on these days. It's still pretty hard to keep up with it all. I still have a bag of apples that I have to decide what to do with, and I really, really don't want to turn that into applesauce. Those are just too wonderful to do that. I've considered today making an apple pie, but I think I've just gotten lazy. So really what I should do is make a number of apple pies and then freeze them and make some apple chips, put them in the dehydrator. I still have not put the ones I made in the freeze dryer yet. So it might be a good idea to get a feeling for the difference between dehydrating and freeze drying. Well, I know what they're like dehydrated. So if I like them freeze dried, maybe I should make more of those, but I still don't know yet. So that'll be coming. That'll be coming. And I'll let you know what the result is. Now, a while back, I did freeze dry some pie, I guess, or I made little tarts and they were awful. I will never freeze dry a pastry with a filling that is a sweet filling again. You know, some things just don't work, and there's no sense in pretending or going through a whole bunch of gyrations to say it works. They were just strange. The pastry had the texture and the taste as though it wasn't freeze-dried at all, like it tasted like a normal pastry, whereas the filling had become a rock hard. And normally when you freeze-dry something, it becomes almost like a styrofoam texture and a melt-in-your-mouth texture. So that was rather a strange combination to have the two of them together. I suspect if I had attempted to make each one of them separate, might have been fine. So I won't do that again. Okay, I still think that it's imperative that you put as much food away as you possibly can for the next year, 2 years. Just make sure that you have something put aside. We still barely haven't touched the beans that I put away 2 years ago, and we still have a lot of rice, but we're starting to dip into that rice, so I think I'll buy more. Now, Mark did make a dish with black beans and shrimp the other day, so we're starting to learn how to eat bean dishes, which is good. I mean, we've had three bean salads, we eat those, and ham type, I can't even recall the name of it now, but with white beans that Mark really loves, we make that, but we make that when the weather gets cold, and of course chili, we use beans. So there are a few dishes that we've had beans, but we're not consumers of beans on a daily basis, although I don't think that's a bad idea. I think that eating beans is actually pretty healthy for you, so it's probably something we should learn to do more. Now, Mark's decided to go back on as much of a carnivore diet as he can, and we'll see how long he sticks to that. It's not an easy diet to stick to, and I'm more into give me my yogurt. I'll have the carnivore dinner with him, but during the day I want my yogurt, and that seems to have done wonders for my stomach. It wasn't just that alone, but I think that it was a contributing factor. So, and I enjoy yogurt, so it all works. Now, there is a lot of craziness going on in the world. We have, of course, the election in the U.S., which is not that far away. Even in Canada, even though our election is a year away from now, it won't be till 2025, there is a push to have it happen sooner, and it could happen sooner, because we don't have the same system that you have in the U.S. Us lowly individuals can only put in our vote, and yes, we should vote, and I intend to vote at every election, whether it's municipal, provincial, and it's usually provincial or federal, and I have no intention of staying home and ignoring it. As a matter of fact, we usually have a little window where you can vote early, but it's a very short window, and Mark and I always take that opportunity and vote during that period rather than the rush towards the end. Now, okay, so US and Canada is going through political upheavals. I know that other countries are going through their own political upheavals, and of course we have two, or should I say four, countries in the midst of serious battles. Of course, both Ukraine and Israel have been attacked unprovoked. They did nothing to provoke these attacks except just be who they are. And somebody decided that they don't. Anyway, Russia on the one hand attacking Ukraine for whatever reason they use to justify it. And of course, Hamas attacking Israel horrifically. And the fact that Israel is fighting back is something that I totally support. You know, sometimes you just have to make your position clear. And as far as I'm concerned, I support Israel. I'm not Jewish. I have a few Jewish friends, not that many. But I don't think that, I think that everyone has a right to self-defense. And they were the ones that were attacked first, therefore they have a right to self-defense. And if they're attacked from all sides because one group decides that they don't deserve to live, well, that's pretty sad and pretty wrong. And more power to them for standing up for what they believe in and fighting back and looking after that tiny little country that they have. It's not as though they have a huge piece of land. They've got a tiny little country. And they have made it what it is through hard work, through effort, and the other ones could have done the same rather than digging tunnels. Bear that in mind. You don't have to spend all your money and all your effort and all your time digging tunnels in order to attack what you presume is your enemy. You could have been developing your own seaside resorts and making them places that people wanted to go to. But that's, once again, an opinion by a nobody. You know, everyone has an opinion. But here we are. The world is still a mess, and it's going to go through more upheavals before it all settles down. I think that this is just the beginning of the chaos. What happens in the U.S. is going to have a serious effect on the countries around the world, even though they may not want to admit that that's the case. Maybe they want to say that they're independent enough and strong enough to stand on their own. I don't think that they are. I think that the U.S. does influence everything that goes on everywhere in the world. Certainly Canada is very much influenced by what happens in the U.S., but then we're an immediate neighbor, and I suspect that Mexico is in the same boat. Now, what they've been doing to the U.S. in the past 3 years is pretty sad. And hopefully a lot of these issues can be rectified, get cut down on the criminal activity. I mean, criminal activity is always present, but you can have a smaller amount of it, or you can just let it run rampant and it will grow. If there is no deterrent, it'll just keep happening. So there are things that need to be done. Now, whether this generation will allow it to just get way bad before it gets better, it's hard to say. It's hard to say. So back to, why do we put food aside? Well, there may be a lot more unemployment. There may be family members that need your assistance, whether it's with housing or with food. So when you can, and if you can, putting aside that little bit of extra, and it could be yourself that needs it. I mean, if you have a job today, all fine and dandy, but if you were to lose it tomorrow, or if your hours are cut back and it's not quite enough to look after your needs, perhaps what you've set aside and stored in the last couple of years, and let me tell you, for me, it's been the last couple of years that have I increased what I've put away. That will have been a worthwhile effort, and I think it's always a worthwhile effort. For those of us who put things away 3 years ago, certainly to replace that product today will probably cost you 50%, if not double, what you paid for it. My coffee stash is gone. Everything that I put away coffee-wise is gone. So, I mean, we drink coffee every day. So the coffee that I buy today cost a whole lot more than what it used to. And olive oil is the same. I used to be able to buy olive oil for $5 on sale for a 1 liter bottle. And today that same bottle is anywhere from $13 to $18. So I'd say that's a pretty hefty increase. Now, there are things that go on in the world that create those situations. It's not just the inflation. It could be, you know, there are a number of issues, poor harvests. And yes, you're going to have poor harvests 1 year and you're going to have good harvests the other year. A lot of us have had very poor gardens this year. I know I have. It's probably been the worst garden that I've ever had. That doesn't mean all of us have had that. Our farmers in Ontario, from what I have seen, the strawberry farm that I went to, the apple farm that I went to, are doing phenomenal. I didn't see as much corn as what I normally do. It seemed to be short-lived where there was an influx of corn. And I'm sure that there's going to be a lot of those root vegetables that are coming to market very soon. So, if you know, in greater quantities and fresher. I think I will still like to make a trip further out to some of these local farms and see what I can find and put up and take advantage of the freeze dryer that I had. Now, I did freeze dry some potato chips, and what I do like about freeze dried vegetables is that you can rehydrate them in seconds. And that is the big difference between freeze dried and dehydrated. Now, dehydrated, it's my little potato chips are rock hard, and I'm thinking that I could turn them into a potato powder, grind it up and turn it into a potato flour, which mixed with water, you're going to have instant mashed potatoes. I believe. I got to try that. So anyway, keep putting food away. It's not going to get any better. And no matter what, even if the president of your choice does win, it doesn't mean that things are going to get better very quickly. It will take probably the next term for things to start to turn around. 2 years, maybe, at the very least, before you start to see anything get better. So I highly recommend that you still stay on top of things, keep an eye on things, and, you know, always darkest before the dawn, and I don't know if we've gotten to the darkest yet. I'm still waiting to see how bad it gets before things change, because it doesn't seem to be improving at all. Anyway, look after yourselves, look after your loved ones. Take care. This is Tony from Her Homestead Skills, and we'll talk to you soon. Bye for now.